After you've successfully trypsinized your cells and they have detached from the bottom of the flask, you will observe lots of gunk at the bottom of the flask. This is okay. You will neutralize the trypsin by mixing it with your DMEM media. The FBS inside of the DMEM media is what is neutralizing the trypsin. So you'll want to have a good ratio for that. For this, we will add 12 milliliters of media to neutralize it. However, you'll only be doing around 5.5 to 6 ml when working with a smaller flask. Bubble action, but that's okay. And now I still add the DMEM to start dropwise. After you've successfully added it dropwise, you will pipette up and down to split the cells from each other. So once you trypsinize them, they are no longer attached to the surface of the flask. However, they are still clumped together. So that pipetting step is what's going to separate them from each other so that you can get an accurate cell count. All right, so now you'll suck up a little bit and then you'll shoot them out pretty quickly. It is important to know, however, if you completely expel all of the contents from the pipette, you will create a lot of bubbles. So what you wanna do is not shoot out everything every single time. If it happens, that's okay, but you want to avoid that as much as you can. So as you can see, I'm just tilting the flask at different angles and expelling them onto the flask to separate. I know it sounds excessive, but you'll want to do this maybe around 100 times. You don't have to keep an exact number, but you want to do it enough times to sufficiently separate them. And be very mindful, this is the step that many students end up sucking way too much on, and this is what typically ruins a filter. So be very mindful that you're watching your media, but you're also watching the pipette, that you're not overshooting or overfilling.